Hi guys, welcome to Travel with Austin. I'm Austin. Today I'm here in my hometown again of Etna, Ohio, and we're going to be taking a look at the Shamrock Motel. If you haven't seen my previous video, I took a look at the motel store. And today we're going to be taking a look at the actual motel part itself. Now, if you didn't watch my last video, basically the whole time I was growing up, these were apartments, not motels. So I only know them as apartments, and they were terrible, terrible apartments. There was drug use, prostitution, people OD'd, people died. So I never came here as a kid because this is a place that you wouldn't want to have a kid near. Funny enough, as abandoned and falling apart, they are probably in better shape. They're probably safer, sorry, than they were years ago. Now, the owner was nice enough to come and let me check out this property. By the time these are up, it is probably demolished by now. Sadly, he has to demolish it. But he did let me come take some photos and some videos. And he's also going to let me go to another property. I don't know if I can do a video there, but he's going to let me photograph it. So we're actually going to start down on this back line, make our way up to the front, and then make our way up there. So, looking in these ones, they're very, very small. I don't actually know if these would have been apartments when they were open, because I don't know if they could have been. They're so very small. As we can see here, this one has a toilet and stuff, and it might connect to the other one, honestly. These ones are in such bad shape, we can't go inside them. We do have bricks falling off the walls. He actually said that he was going to save these bricks and make a thing at the other property he bought from. As you can see, we have floors falling in. You can't smell it, but there's tons of mildew. So basically, we really cannot go in any of these. Even the best of them are in terrible shape. So we're just going to walk by them. That one you can actually still see the sink is in it. And there's a toilet. We're actually going to step up to this one. So there's lots of archways in these. I hope you guys can see that well. I really like archways, so that's kind of cool for me. Now, as we move this way, we kind of get into rooms that I think are bigger. This one's actually really interesting, and I have not checked it out yet. So the floor is completely fallen in, as you can see, so we can't go inside of it. But this part right here where it connects is very interesting to me. So we're going to go around back and look at that, because I did not see that earlier. Just see what it is. Take a look in here as we go by. So the fire department has been using this for a lot of practice, cutting out holes and stuff. I actually asked him if they were going to do a controlled burn as the when they demolish it. And they're not allowed to do that because it is so close to Route 40. So let's take a look again. That floor that fell in. So, I don't know how they're going to demolish it. So, here's this little back area. This is kind of just like a weird little hallway with a room in it. These were very cheap apartments, if you can't tell. I actually have no idea how much they rented for. But you can get semi-decent apartments here for around $506 a month. So, I imagine they're way cheaper than that. So we can kind of see now that we're getting into this little area where it's cottages, basically. And there's still some old concrete that goes back there. I'm really not sure how much of this place went and got demolished over the years. I know it used to be in much better condition. And it was actually very popular when it was opened as a motel. The owner, very nice guy, told me that Bob Hope stayed here. So that was an interesting fact. So as we walk around, we got some tent stakes. We're going to look in the first one of these cottages. These actually have fireplaces in them, which is pretty nice. But they're still very small. Which I don't know if these would be worth more or less. I mean, a fireplace is generally sought after, but these are so small. These ones are also in pretty bad condition. I think there's one of them that we can go into. Let me see if there is or not. Technically we could go in that one, I guess, but there's not a thing in there. So, I mean, we can take a big look at these. So like I was saying earlier, they've had the fire department out here doing stuff. And when he bought this place, he was actually told he wasn't allowed to walk inside the buildings. Not because they're unsafe, which, I mean, they are. But because there were so many rusted needles from drug users here that he just wasn't allowed to. And he had to pay a team to come through, take everything out. His daughter, who I met, said that they were wearing hazmat suits and stuff. And now that the cleaning is finally complete, you can go in them. Although, as you can tell, a lot of them are torn apart, not in good condition. But at least there's no rusty needles to worry about. So, this is the back section. This is the section you usually don't see, honestly, because it is hidden behind everything else. And it is the most destroyed section. Now, as we go to this front section up here, we're actually going to be able to go in through quite a few of them. Now, I probably won't go through that many just because there's nothing left in them and they're all the same. But we're going to start here. These have garages. But as you can see, unless some floor was removed or something, the garage is like a 2-inch drop. So, I actually knew some people who lived here, and one of them actually lived in the garage. So, that's just to tell you, like, how bad it was here, how generally poor these people were. This actually has a nice original door. Reminds me of the doors in my house. And like I said, archway doors. Again, in its heyday, it used to be very beautiful. Now it's not. And it's kind of weird how they're all slightly different. And as we walk by these garages, you can see where the fire department cut out things. So here, we'll go in here. Still got some nice carpeting down. An original door. Then here's the garage where the fire department, it looks like the fire department cut a triangle and then they decided to make it a full square, or maybe somehow someone kicked out the square. Yeah, but just, I don't know if it's easy to see on the screen, but how small these places are. My bedroom is bigger than these apartments. So, we're just gonna keep walking by them. If I see anything of interest, we'll stop. Oh, well, this has a lot of glass, so I can't go in. But there is an attic space here. That's interesting. Did not know that. Oh, and wow, look at this one. It is nice colors, really nice painted. I don't know how much control the tenants had over these places, so the conditions might look better or worse depending on who owned them. Oh, and see, this one doesn't have a garage, but they extended it and put a window in. So this place is just honestly extremely neat because everything is different. In fact, as we get over here, it looks like none of these actually have garage doors anymore, but they just have extended apartments. There we have one of the doors. So that's pretty interesting, honestly. So yes, this is the front motel area. Now, before I end this video, we're actually going to take a look at this building up here. Now, if I'm right, I believe this building would have been where, when this was a motel, you'd drive up, you'd check in, you'd go to your room. Right now, it is being used for storage. So we're just going to take a quick look at it real quick. So first of all, I love this building because I'm a sucker for this little three-window design right here. Then we're going to take a look inside. It is being used for storage right now, as you can tell. We actually have some original doors and stuff here, which is very neat. Looks like a lot of insulation or something. But yeah, so this has been the actual motel of the Shamrock Motel. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe. I make new videos once a week. Now, I do have one more video coming from here. And it's actually about this house on the hill right here. But I'm not sure how safe this house is. So stay tuned next week.